The Guardians have disbanded, and Thanos sees this as his chance to finally stomp them. Welcome to Comic Storian's Complete Story Series. This is the most epic way to recap your favorite comics because we explain the bare bones of what happened along with music, voices, and sound effects. Now this is a special episode, because you probably saw the name. The end. This is the conclusion to Brian Michael Bendis' Guardians of the Galaxy. When the first movie came out, he created a new comic line to reflect that team, and we've been following those adventures. We have the whole series in a playlist. But if you want to know quickly what happened, the Guardians came together, they discovered the origin of the Venom symbiote, they found the Black Vortex leading to ultimate power, and they defeated Peter Quill's father. They then went on a journey to discover someone close to Groot, teamed up with Deadpool, and Peter took over as the ruler of Spartax. They then freed a slave planet before finally being dragged into Civil War II, where their ship was destroyed. Stranded on Earth, they discovered something. Thanos was being held captive on Earth, and Peter Quill knew and told no one. Unable to trust the fact that their leader was keeping that information from them, the Guardians of the Galaxy officially disbanded. Gamora looks over the city that is her objective. Her father is Thanos, and her mission has been to kill him. And Peter Quill neglected to tell her where he was being held. She looks at the most secure building on the planet, the SHIELD headquarters, the prison of Thanos from a distance. She knows what she has to do, and she's going to do it alone. Alpha Flight members arrive to talk her down as she simply looks at them. Earth soldiers, do not force my hand. And they respond by telling the greatest assassin in the universe to surrender. Gamora jumps right at them, deflecting a shot into Sasquatch, and then she kicks Aurora in the face before America gets a shot in, drawing blood from her, throwing her into the rooftop. Spectrum then opens fire trying to bury her, and Gamora takes the full blast. America then turns to Spectrum, asking if she was trying to kill her, and Spectrum tells her that she hopes not. She's a fan of Gamora. Luckily, Gamora snaps out of it and throws America aside before leaping back in to continue the conflict. She deflects Aurora's blast again, slicing at Sasquatch, and deflects Spectrum's shot back at Aurora, removing her. And as she falls to the streets down below, Alpha Flight runs over to see where she landed, but they can't find her anywhere. She slipped into a little boy's room, telling him, shh, and then she walks through his house quietly, heading for the front door. Except America sucker punched her through the door, through the house, and into the parents' bedroom. With that, Gamora was captured and restrained. When she woke up, she found herself face to face with Captain Marvel, her friend and the one who had locked up Thanos and didn't tell her. Captain Marvel explains that they didn't tell her because he's her father. She didn't want to hurt Gamora, nor did she know how Gamora would handle it. But she has an update. Thanos escaped and he's no longer on Earth. He got free during the superhero Civil War and she has no idea how. Gamora sees that she is up at a space station and Captain Marvel tells her, "You're free to go. Go find your father and end this, but don't do it on Earth. If we see you here again, we're going to have to arrest you, and I hope that if we ever see each other again, it's as friends, Gamora." She salutes her and leaves her there. Alpha Flight, meanwhile, has been meeting with the gladiator of the Shi'ar Empire, as he's going to take Gamora far, far away from here. Except one slight problem. She managed to get out and swap places with another green girl, because if Captain Marvel wouldn't tell her that Thanos was here, why would Gamora believe her when she said that he had left? So she makes her way to the SHIELD headquarters, running through explosions and distractions until she finds one of the deepest cells, where she opens it up to see that Thanos is in fact gone. And then the door slams shut. A hologram of Captain Marvel pops up, informing Gamora that she asked her to leave. She explained that Thanos escaped, and now she's broken into the SHIELD headquarters, and this is a crime. They aren't going to just let her go. She punches the door until their fists are bloodied, shouting, "You can't do this to me!" Meanwhile, as the Guardians disbanded, Angela, the daughter of Odin, and the sister of the Odin son, flew off to resolve some of her own issues. She went looking for a friend named Sarah, only to find an assassin. He arrives swinging his weapon at her, and she roundhouses him in the head before he throws her down to the streets. So, she throws a lawn gnome at him, and then she flips over him before throwing him into the streets herself. They exchange blows back and forth as he explains that he came looking for Gamora of Titan. But Angela will do as she kicks him and buries his head into the ground before jumping high into the sky to bring her blade to his face. He catches it, and she stabs him in the back. She smiles as she looks down at him. "I can make you an offer. I have what I want. I have a ship that can get you off of this planet tonight. You're going to want to leave. He is coming. Everyone in the galaxy knows." "Who?" "He is on his way to take Earth once and for all."
"Is he alone?"
"No."
Angela leaves as the police arrive on the scene, and she looks up to the sky. Thanos, up above the Earth, approaching it fast, is everyone that hates Earth to finish the Earth once and for all. Out of the negative zone, all of Earth's enemies decided that it was time. Annihilus, the Queen of the Brood, the Badoon, are all talking to Thanos because the Earth is a threat. It has caused problems, and it is known that the end of the universe will begin with it. So all of the beings in space have decided to just remove this threat once and for all by destroying the planet. In this endeavor, they decided to bring in Thanos, the Mad Titan, but he has one demand. They will not destroy Earth. They will take it, and he will have it. The other threats of the galaxy try to convince him that this is a terrible idea, but it is the only way that he'll join their battle. Over in the S.H.I.E.L.D. helicarrier, Captain Marvel, Peter Quill, and Rocket Raccoon are all sitting trying to come up with a plan so that the Guardians can get off the world again. Peter has been involved in a bank heist and then community service, while Rocket was just blowing up things in New York, but we'll get to those stories soon enough. Rocket stands on the table, eyeballing Carol angrily. We came all the way across the Fratuckin' galaxy! Please don't torture me with this again. To help you win a stupid superhero Fratuck Fest! I know the sequence of events that have led to this. We help, you win, and our ship gets blowed up! Peter turns to her. Carol, there has to be something you can do to help us. And she pulls up a map that leads to a Earth spaceship scrapyard, with Rocket's eyes going wide. You have a Fratuckin' spaceship graveyard and I'm just now hearing about it? Meanwhile, over at the Brooklyn Bridge, Kitty Pryde and Ben Grimm the Thing, two former Guardians of the Galaxy, look up to see the invasion. Groot, who has moved over to Central Park to become a tree living a peaceful life, is suddenly shrouded by these ships, to which he says, I am Groot. And Flash Thompson, Venom, looks out the window as he was trying to get a new job, and he sees it approaching. The Guardians might not be friends right now, but they see when they're needed, hopefully. Across a loudspeaker from the invasion force, everyone begins to hear a voice calling out, People of Earth! Hi, this is not an invasion. It is not an act of war or hostility. This is a greeting. We are inviting you to join the galactic common good of species. But there is one little thing that you have to allow us to do before we can welcome you with open arms. We have to remove a cancer from the galaxy that is hiding on your planet. You are harboring intergalactic terrorists known as the Guardians of the Galaxy. Once we remove them, we will start the process of inclusion. And then we see it's Thanos making those empty threats. Over at the S.H.I.E.L.D. headquarters, Peter suits up, and Rocket walks past him. You gotta get me to the spaceship graveyard. Rocket, Thanos is right outside of the door. I knows! All you ever do is talk about shooting him in the butt. It's literally all you talk about. You gotta get me to those spaceships or we're all gonna die. So Peter turns to Carol. How fast can you fly? And then we see Carol holding Rocket on her back, hitting top speeds, while Rocket's lips peel back from the insanity of it all. Peter pops on his mask and he turns to see Drax. And Drax is smiling, because Thanos just landed in the S.H.I.E.L.D. helicarrier. The first man into the fight is Drax himself, and the first thing that he does is punch Thanos in the nose. As he's thrown back, Drax jumps high, but Thanos catches him out of midair.
The Destroyer still lives. I would have thought you long dead alongside your pathetic wife.
So Drax kicks Thanos in the nuts. Thanos then throws him off the side of the helicarrier. Peter rockets in with the might of S.H.I.E.L.D. behind him, but as he's about to enter the fight, Carol calls back, Peter, I know where Gamora is. We're holding her.
You're holding her?
You know why. Okay. Well, I don't want to tell you how to do your job, then maybe now is a good time to let her out. Peter then begins his battle with Thanos, wondering, where are all of the superheroes? There's like 15 spider people. There are so many X-Men. And then Thanos gives him a death glare.
Goodbye, Star-Lord.
But as he goes in to kill him, we hear something.
I.
And it seems to be getting closer.
Am.
And closer still until it sucker punches Thanos.
Groot!
Peter raises his gun. Psst. I knew you were gonna say that. And he opens fire. Thanos grabs Groot, throwing him in the way of the blast, and Peter yells out sorry as Agent Venom jumps in from behind him, telling him,
I got this.
As S.H.I.E.L.D. is calling out to abandon the ship, Groot, Venom, and Star-Lord begin to beat down on the Mad Titan. Meanwhile, up in space, the enemies of Earth are all seeing what is happening.
Thanos really is a madman. He fell apart the moment we gave him the stage.
Annihilus turns to the Queen of the Brood.
I say we go with the original plan.
And the Badoom Command agrees. Thus, they begin the destruction of Earth with Thanos still on it. Down on the planet, Thanos reaches out for Peter to try and finish him off, only to have Kitty Pryde arrive, sticking her fingers up Thanos' nose so that she can flip over his head. She then phases him through the floor, dropping him down to the planet where a rocky fist is awaiting. And as he lands, we hear the famous line,
It's clobbering time! You're welcome, Shins!
And then he throws Thanos as far as he can hit him. Thanos gets up, blood dripping from his face.
I will make you all watch them burn!
Meanwhile, as the attack force Force gets ready for the massive destruction of Earth. They call out for the Queen of the Brood to give the word, but instead they hear another voice. The Queen of the Brood will no longer be joining your Alliance of Blood. And then we see Angela sitting on the throne. She and the rest of her kind have fallen. I am Angela, the Hunter Angel, the Odin's daughter, and never come back. And with that, she smiles. Annihilus and the Badoon command structure all agree. It's time to leave. Except as they go for their grand escape, there's something standing in their way. Captain Marvel and a horde of ships that Rocket Raccoon rebuilt. Down on Earth, every Guardian of the Galaxy, except for a missing Tony Stark, stands before the fallen Mad Titan. Yet, he still tries to intimidate them. The Earth is mine! Really? Since when? Did you bring your receipt? We're really gonna have to see your receipt. And then he hears one more voice that he hasn't seen yet, as Gamora stands behind him. Hello, Father. Needless to say, I have dreamed of this exact moment. The moment before I execute you with my own hands.
Gamora, all of this could have been yours. All of it. But instead...
She looks at him, and memories of her past begin to flood in her head, and she grits her teeth and charges her weapon up. All of her friends look on at her, unable to, unwilling to stop her. And she tells him, after chasing you across the galaxy, back with a crazed bloodlust in my eyes, to see you like this instead. It seems it is just fine. He gets up furious.
You sicken me!
And they all jump in to finish off Thanos. Shortly after this, the Nova Corps arrives to arrest Thanos and haul him off of Earth, finally. No words were really exchanged nor needed in the farewell, because it was time for the Guardians to leave the planet. Drax shook hands with his fellow warrior Ben Grimm, while Peter and Kitty Pryde decided to leave it where it was. She would stay on Earth and he would move on. The X-Men need her more right now. Venom and Rocket said their goodbyes, and Captain Marvel took selfies with Gamora. As Kitty, Angela, Ben, Venom, and Carol all watched, the Guardians of the Galaxy took off back into space. And with that, the Guardians are going to be on many more adventures, but the epic journey that Brian Michael Bendis brought them on comes to a close. That concludes The Guardians of the Galaxy as written by Brian Michael Bendis. Now, as of this video coming out, they're already launching a new line, and it's being written by Jerry Dugan, the guy who writes Deadpool. So, as you can tell, since I'm a fan of Guardians of the Galaxy and Deadpool, I'm insanely excited for this, and I can't wait to see what's gonna happen. But this is the end of an era for The Guardians of the Galaxy. Some people liked this run, some people didn't like this run. For me, I enjoyed seeing the movie versions of the characters in print, watching them be quippy and have fun and go on their adventures. And I hope you did too. You can subscribe to this channel to get all kinds of Guardians of the Galaxy content this month and in general, and you can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at ComicStorian, where I want to hear your thoughts on this run. Did you enjoy it? Did you hate it? Just need to know. I'll see you guys next time right here.